Your name is Callum Gilhooly?
Aye.
And you live at 34 Polworth Gardens?
Aye. How do you know that?
It's my job to know that.
Is that what you do for a living? Just know my address? Who pays you?
You are 28 years old and are currently employed as a barman.
Have you been following me?
I take it you understand the charges?
No.
You understand how you came to be in court?
Aye, I got the 24 bus. Hung around outside and then I came in through that door over there.
Mr. Gilhooly, you are charged that from the moment you first met my client, you have continually harassed him with conversations, phone calls, and anecdotes about your motorbike. Furthermore, on numerous occasions, you have rendered my client senseless with boredom, to the point at which he now screams whenever the phone rings, will only go out dressed in a balaclava and sunglasses, and on one occasion he sold you his house for £10, rather than watch, and I quote, a Davy Bond movie. With you. Mr. Gilhooly, how do you plead? Mr. Gilhooly, look.
What is it?
No, listen. No, to me, up here.
Oh, sorry, right. No, I was just wondering why you're wearing that wig. Because it's not as if you're bald. I can see you've got plenty of hair, and then I thought, well, maybe it's a present. Or a joke. Or maybe you wear it to make you look taller. Or to make you look like you've got a wig on. Which it does, by the way. And then I thought, well, it's none of my business. I mean, you don't ask me why I wear an anorak, which I appreciate. But I don't mind telling you, seeing as you're asking. The reason being that I like it, I prefer it, and it's got lots of pockets.
See what I mean?
Oh, hi, John. Thanks for coming to support me. I'm not quite sure what's going on here. I think this guy's been following me. I reckon it's because he likes my anorak. Actually, I reckon he's a bit of a weirdo, what with a wig and all that. But don't worry, I've got him on the run.
Mr. Gilhooly, it's your friend here that's brought the charges. It's him you've bored to death.
John's always doing daft things. He's a brilliant practical joke. I'll phone him up for ages and he won't answer. And I'll go round and ring the bell for ages and he still doesn't answer. Then I look in the window and he's hiding behind the sofa. He's always doing daft things.
Mr. Gilhooly, do you plead guilty or not guilty?
I don't know. What do you do?
Well, it would be easier for all of us if you pled guilty. Then we could all go home.
Well, that's okay. I don't have to be home for ages. Think. I'll plead the other one.
Not guilty.
Oh, thanks. That was quick. What made you change your mind?
I haven't changed my mind. I'm asking you what your plea was.
Again? Chris, we're going round in circles. Is this your first time?
No further questions, Mr. Gilhooly.
I was only asking you if it was your first time, but if you don't want me asking any further questions, I won't.
I have no further questions for you!
So what are we going to do now, then?
Mr. Doherty, please take the stand.
It's good fun, this, eh, John? Reminds me of Perry Manson. You know, the a man called Fireside. The lazy detective. Not as good as the fat one, Columbus. Or my favourite, Kodak.
Now, Mr. Doherty.
John, hey, these boxes are great. Because they're quite high up and you can see down. You've got to be careful, though, not to go down yourself. Because then you won't see it. I mean, I can't see I can see the wood inside.
Please! Be quiet!
What is it? I can't hear anything.
Mr. Doherty, is this Callum Gilhooly?
Oh, I like the way he gets the easy ones.
Yes, it is.
And how long have you known him?
Since the beginning of time.
And you would like this now to stop?
More than anything.
Now, I understand you have a tape of Mr. Gilhooly speaking, which you would like to play to the court.
Anyway, John, this new stapler I was telling you about is brilliant, because not only does it staple things, but it does only staple things, but it staples them really well, and it's black, and you can put the staples inside, and they're dead cheap and last for ages, because I hardly ever use a stapler, unless I do, or maybe take it out to the garden for a walk.
Hey, that was-
was interesting. I was listening to that.
So was I. You're on your own.
Oh, God, no.
Don't worry, John. I'll help you.
Oh, God.
Now, I don't know, Your Honour, what the charges are that you've brought against my trumped-up friend here. But I tell you, they won't stick, because he's brilliant, and he's my mate, and he's brilliant.
Mr. Doherty, you got anything that you'd like to say?
Yes, would you please send me to prison?
Good idea. 15 years. I'll come with you.
Make up, make up. I'm sweating like an oxen. Like an ox.